Ancient Egyptians believed the burial tomb should contain everything you need for the afterlife, so kings were buried with food and gold and beer and weapons, even their pets. But what about the ladies of the court? Where are they at, though? Hey everyone, thanks for watching DNews today. I am Trace. One of the most famous pharaohs of Egypt was, and still is, King Tut. But Tutankhamun's mother, Nefertiti, is a far more intriguing political and cultural figure to Egyptologists. She is legendary for her beauty, but also because she and her husband, Akhenaten, turned Egypt toward the cult of Aten, the sun god, and away from polytheism. Nefertiti died before Tut, and no one knew exactly where she was buried, though they've been looking for decades, and technology may have finally revealed Nefertiti was hiding in plain sight this whole time. In a paper titled, "The Burial of Nefertiti?" Lead researcher Nicholas Reeves writes that he believes Nefertiti is buried inside King Tut's tomb. Or more accurately, actually, Tut was buried inside Nefertiti's tomb. He believes that there is a secret chamber behind an elaborately painted wall in Tut's burial chamber, which houses the legendary queen. Tut's tomb is highly trafficked by tourists, so to protect the original from human destruction, a Spanish company took high-resolution photos of the hieroglyphs and paintings inside and then created a reconstruction. Looking at those photos, Reeves discovered fissures in a wall which might hide secret doors. Obviously, they couldn't go in and break down the walls, so instead, the Egyptian Ministry of Antiquities scanned the room with infrared thermography. Essentially, scientists and engineers measured the surface temperatures of the walls with infrared cameras. Two sections of the walls had a different temperature reading, meaning that there was a space behind them. Reeves believes one is a storeroom and the other is Nefertiti's lost burial chamber. More research is obviously needed before they can determine if Nefertiti's tomb is actually back there. I mean, they can't just cut into the wall and find her yet, but wow, this could be huge. I love the idea that technology is making archaeologists drool, and this isn't the only way. In a Scan Pyramids joint effort by Cairo University, the University of Laval in Quebec, and Nagoya University in Japan, researchers pointed these infrared thermography scanners at the Great Pyramid at Giza, and after only 2 weeks, found another undiscovered tomb. Normally, variation in external stone temperatures are only about 0.1 to 0.5 degrees, but in one area on the pyramid, the stones were 6 degrees different. The researchers think that they can use lasers, drones, and infrared scanners to get a picture of the internal structure of the pyramid without having to drill in and destroy part of this historical structure. Advances in technology help archaeologists gather information about ancient and fragile artifacts without destructively manipulating them or cutting them open or moving ancient bones. The lasers they mention are probably LIDAR, or light detection and ranging technology. Using laser light, archaeologists can get super accurate measurements of historical sites, which let them create 3D models. These computer models can then reveal details about construction, building techniques, and so on, especially sensitive bits or areas for further exploration. Drones and robots can also help get scans or images from hard-to-reach places. Like back in the 90s, a tiny crawling robot was sent into an undisturbed burial chamber in the Great Pyramid. Even satellites are put to work in the hunt for our history. 400 miles above the Nile's shores, infrared satellite pictures revealed 17 pyramids, 3,000 settlements, and 1,000 tombs across Egypt. It took many hundreds of hours of trial and error, but newer techniques are looking at AI systems to find these settlements, and either way it was quicker than going around and categorizing them all on the ground. Though there's no substitute for getting in there with a brush, magnifying glass, and, you know, your phalanges, archaeologists are finding technology to be a powerful ally, and obviously I just love this stuff. If you have something that you love, like Egyptology, you could go to domain.com and grab a website to share your love with the world. Egypt.news is available, or, you know, Egypt.expert or KingTut.ninja, whatever you want. No domain will help you tell your story like a .net or .com domain name, and since you watch us, you can get 15% off domains and web hosting if you use the offer code DNews. What's your favorite story from world history? King Tut? The sacking of Carthage by Rome? I love that one. The Huns in China? How about the ancient history of alcohol? We've got that last one there for you. Some scientists made wine using this ancient recipe and they tasted it. You want to know what it tasted like? Just watch this video. Unlike today, milk and water were actually not considered healthful beverages. They were full of disease and pestilence. But thanks to the bacteria-fighting properties of alcohol, societies were able to stay nourished and hydrated. Thanks for watching, everyone. Please subscribe, and we will see you next time on DNews.